Hey, I'm back. Miss me? Okay, anyhow. I just went through my mom's old paints. Mostly she has a bunch of oil paints. These look like they are the water mixable ones. We're going to swatch these out and see if they're any good. Some of them don't have any of the pigment information on them because of their age, but we're going to go ahead and swatch those out. I got a couple of different brands here. Apparently they mix too. I don't know how she did. She's never a professional artist, but she did actually take the artist course. She almost finished it, but then she got married and had kids. And we kind of kept her from doing that. So, let's start with the Alexander ones. Alexander, I got two of the permanent reds. So I think we'll use this one here. Because I don't see any point in using both of them. And this one here has already been opened, it looks like. Looks like we might need to get a paper towel and clean these parts up. So I'll be right back with a paper towel. Oh wait, I have one. I do have one. Here we go. I don't like it doing that. Okay, so here we go. We're just going to wipe off the outside of this here. Best we can, because we don't want it getting all messy. This right here, and then we'll wipe off the inside of this thing here, because you don't want them gluing shut, because this, once it's dried, is dried, it ain't coming up, at least as far as I know how to solvent. And I don't have any solvent, so here we go. Can't get this here mixed to the medium there. Looks like it did. Okay. New brush. Okay. So this is permanent red, one by Alexander. Oh, that is pretty. Isn't that? That's a pretty color. I like it. Normally I don't make big swatches, but I just want to get all the color off the brush. So the color I can off the brush, so I don't have to get them into more water. You know? Maybe these don't. Okay. Be right back because I think I need some soap to put in here. So we're going to do that real quick. Maybe some more alcohol. So I will be right back. Hold on while I put you. Okay, I'm back. It does wash out, just needs soap, not just water. So I got some dish soap. That's what I used. That seemed to work. If I could just get my foot where it needs to be. Okay, there we go. So we're not going to be using brush. We'll use one that's in that shape. Over here are one of the ones I don't really care that much for. So get some over here. Hold on. Use this one. This should be a good one. What do you think? Okay. Sorry for the interruption. So, yeah, that is Zender's permanent red, which does not give any pigment information. Next, we have 242 yellow ochre, which I don't think has been opened before. Looking at it. Let's see if we can get it fixed. There we go. Should be nice. Alrighty. Brush wet. You were wondering, this is the Canson acrylic slash oil paper. That is yellow ochre. Paint on that brush to start off with. But I am going to get it clean. Later. All right, there we go. Okay, so after that, we have Indian yellow. These here are not the water mixable oils. Okay. That going for us, don't we? Yellow. bit of it. Seems to be kind of separated. So there. I need some linseed oil or something for that. Yeah, that one does not seem to be doing too good. No, I'm not too worried about it because I do not have a cut on my finger. And I'm not healed it. Here I go. Yep. There, none of my pants. So I do have to remind myself. Then we have deep orange. Actually, I don't have it here. So let's just see if we can get it over there. Okay, let's see. Because I don't want that getting. Nice. I like that. It's a nice orange. Next we have violet. Okay. Let's see what violet looks like. That looks pretty darn. It looks very, very dark. It's not like violet to me. Okay, it is a very, very dark purple. Looks black for the most part. It is a dark, dark purple. Okay. We have permanent rose. Looks like it's going to be a pretty color. I Interesting color. Let's see what happens if I next we have cadmium yellow hue. That's a pretty color. Oh yeah, that is a pretty yellow. Guess I still got some of that other color. I still have a little bit of that primrose in there. It's kind of dulling it from what it looked like. Yep, there is some in there. Kind of color theory and color mixing. That works for all the medias. The colors are pretty much the same. See if we can get that more of a true color on it. Looks like here we go. Yeah, that's what it really looks like right there. Nice bright yellow. See, pretty. It does. I feel really good with the permanent rose. I must say, that's a nice thing to know. Cadmium yellow hue, so there is actual cadmium in it. So. But they do seem to clean out pretty good. Okay, next we have Prussian blue. Use Prussian. This one's Prussian blue. I love blues. They are some of my all-time favorite colors. Actually, blue is my all-time favorite color. Dark blue. Let's see. Very, So this one I might have to put it in here to see if I can get some. Let's see. There, because I don't think I have to put this in. Alrighty. Let me see here if I can get some of this here. Brush. Okay, burnt umber. That is a dark brown. Next we have old sienna. And this is a little crimson go. Oh, there it is. Looks like a nice milk chocolate. I like chocolate. In case you wanted to know, I actually love chocolate. So there's that. So next we have one is alizarin crimson, which also appears to be kind of new, and so, that's probably why the, let's see here, what that is, it's okay, that takes care of the Alexander. Thanks. Now we go to the Gumbacher ones, which we have here. These do have the pigment information. This one here is Sap Green PG7, PB15, PO49, and PY150. Okay, that one looks like it might need a little bit. A nice green, dark. Oh yes, love it, love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. Green, another burnt umber. No, sorry, burnt sienna. Not burnt umber. This is PBR7. Kind of in between those two. It's a little bit darker than the Alexander one. Still, it's a nice warm brown. Do the rest of the Gumbacher ones and then I'll switch to the next thing over. Yeah, I know this is probably not the best way to do this, but what am I gonna do about it? Okay, now. So the last Gumbacher one. Payne's Gray, which is PB29 and PBK6. And I don't think this one's been used either. Looks nice. Okay. I prefer indigo to Payne's Gray, but that's just me. Maybe that seems to go good. Okay, so pretty much. Absolutely. Next, we have the Melba Artist Oil Colors, and in those we have Sienna, which is PG7. Okay, so we have our Sienna. Kind of like this one better. Don't know why, but I like that one better. Those three. Sienna. Okay. Is there any crimson? So I'm not expecting that to happen. Alrighty, so that one is no good. So this one can go in the trash. Okay. Crimson does not work, so we'll just leave it at. So next we have Sap Green, which is PG7 and PO43. Pigments in it than the other one. Remove it. Let's get this stuff in here. Sap Green. Oh, that is beautiful. Great. Look at that. I like this one better than that one. Gorgeous. Okay, so next we have cobalt blue. It's a little dried out. Sure. This is PB29 and PG7. Then we have what we got here, Prussian blue. If I can get it open. Let's see if we have and this one seems to not work either, so those two don't work. So then we have next we have Kiwi Orange, which is PR108. This one here is going to work either. And it looks like that one there does not work either. So that is three of those. Get rid of. Next we have Viridian, which I think the pigment information is still kind of off, right? This one here is older than those. In there, mainly because I like green. Okay. So the Viridian. Let's see if we can get this mixed up a little bit. So again, this here. Look at that red green. Do like that color. I saw some that said pleasurable. Really don't seem to be washable. Okay, and I missed writing down the paint scary. I know I did that. But I did, so there's my pencil. Where'd my pencil go? Really? Okay, there we go. We're getting some out. Probably not very good. This is going to be paint spray. I'm just gonna see what I can see. Okay, then we have white. Don't know what white, but it's white. So let's see if it's good, shall we? It's a huge tube, so I hope it is. But it appears that it isn't. This one here appears to be no good either, so here we go. Leaves us a few more. I have a WN Artist Indian Yellow, made in England by Winsor & Newton. I did not know that was Winsor & Newton. Okay, anyway, must be an old way of putting it. Let's see if this one here is going to mix. They're okay. Let's see if I can get this here mixed. Let's see if it will. I is not really wanting to mix in there, now is it? Okay, so let's see. Yeah, that one's not any good either. I'm gonna have to pause you guys for the up there, and then we will finish. Okay. Okay. We have a few more colors to swatch, and then we'll be done. Okay. Here we have the Liquitex Artist Oil Cadmium Red Light, and it is PR 108. Let's see if we can get any of this out. I'm sure we can. Yes, that one looks creamy as all get out. Nice. So let's see that we can get this cadmium red light. Oh, that is a nice warm red, isn't it? Look at that. That is a nice color. These paints are probably 30 years old. They're at least 20 years old. Okay, there's some colors I forgot to write. I think we have a sap green by Bob Ross. So let's see what this one looks like, shall we? If we can. Okay, never mind. That one does not work at all. So it goes over there with the. Does not work. It's okay. That leaves these three, Winsor & Newton washable watercolors. Let's start with this one. We have a lemon yellow, which is PY3. These are washable, water mixable anyhow, so this one here should be easier to clean up. I just want to make sure I get this one. Lemon yellow is one of my favorite yellows. There we go. And here is, look at that, that is beautiful. I think I added too much water. And then we have cadmium red hue, which is PR188 and PR170. Beautiful. Beautiful. Absolutely. Beautiful orange there. This one here. And leaves French ultramarine. And some silver powder, the other ones. Let's see here. Just touch it in here to this yellow. Here. Okay. Here. It's a nice green. And a sappy spring green. This little bit in the top, so the other one is a lot butter something, so I'm clean all this up. Okay. So there we have my 30-year-old oil paints that I got from my mom. Water soluble ones, I think I'll keep. I don't know. exactly sure about the other ones. But there you have it. And just so you know, water soluble ones do not mix with the other ones. I checked it out for you. And it smells like oil paint in here now. Oh well. That's all for now. Bye.